buzzing round your hide. I'm a king bee. I'm buzzing round your hive. I can make good honey, baby, if you let me come inside. Hey! I'm a king bee. I'm buzzing round your hive. I'm a king bee. I'm buzzing round your hive. I can make good honey, baby, if you let me come inside. And I'm able
apologize. I'm really stumbling tonight. I'm exhausted. But this music will bring me right back to life. Give it up for your incredible bass player, Sam Arnold. And the band leader, keyboardist for the evening, from the band DG3, Darrell Grant. Thank you so much for coming out and checking out this great show and supporting your great cause. I hope you have a wonderful night. Thank you.
Much. Thanks for joining us here on the 9 o'clock set. It's not late, is it, really? People are like, oh, people want to come out at 9 o'clock, it's too late. It's like, really? Didn't used to be late when I was a younger person. Anyway, thank you for joining us. Once again, please put your hands together for Machado Mijiga on the drums. And for Sam Arnold on the bass. So, as Aaron said, this is our first gig in Portland. So we've been working on this music for some time, and really excited to actually have a group that was willing to rehearse and put in time with the music and learn a bunch of new music. I do a lot of different projects, and I wanted to do something that wasn't a project. This is just me and my music and with some people that I love to play with. I guess maybe that's what happens when you turn 60. You finally like get to just call the shots. but the thing is, these guys are just, you know, bringing a whole new musical understanding, generations of different sounds and things to the music that I brought to them. So I feel like it's no longer my music, it's really our music, hence the DG3. We can use your initials next time. I want to say something I forgot last time, which is that there is a mailing list here, an email list on this music stand. So if you want to sign up, a lot of really wonderful things happening. Just yesterday, day before yesterday, released the first single for my new record. That's called The New Black, and an incredible film, music film by the wonderful filmmaker here in Kalima Abioto, just put just amazing film together around the single for this record. So that is out and available on YouTube. And we're going to have some cool stuff coming out, some stuff you might want to buy, some stuff you might want to hang on to, and I mean listen to, but also like just, you know, carry around town. Anyway, you can find out about that by signing up on the email list. If you want to pre-order the CD, there's a QR code that you can scan, run on your phone, and it'll take you right to where you can pre-order the CD. So that's coming out, or the digital file for the many people who no longer know what a CD even is. Appreciative about that. We're gonna go on with a song that this is the first time we've ever played it actually, and this was something that was written for Juneteenth, which we are celebrating today, and so. This is it's a song called Fresh, and not fresh like Whole Foods fresh, but fresh like we used to say back in the 90s when something was dope. We would say it was fresh, and this song reminds me of that period. I lived in Brooklyn in the 90s. I lived right around the corner from Spike Lee, and so I remember when the movie Do the Right Thing came out. And that was just like, this song reminds me of that period. That was fresh. Thank you. Thank you. Machado Mijiga on the drums. All right, we're going to do a jazz standard now, but not in a jazzy way. I know most of the people in the front row, actually the majority of the people in the front row, know exactly what I'm talking about, because this is what we make them do in order to graduate from the university I teach at. Play a jazz song, not in a jazz way. So this is that version of that. This is it's called Star Eyes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, something different. So, some of this music is brand new, and then some of this music is really, really old. So old that it's brand new. So I wrote a song, I don't even remember, maybe a couple of years after I moved here. I had a band in the, how many people remember the old Jimmy Max? Like the, yeah, the one, well, the old Jimmy Max, like the one before the new Jimmy Max that closed. But so when I moved here in 1997, one of the first gigs I had was a steady Wednesday night at that club. And I played in a band I started called the People Music Project. Marilyn Keller was in that band. Dan Ballmer was in that band. Anthony Jones, who was the drummer with Pink Martini for many years, he was in that band. He was 17 years old, like a freshman at PSU. And this bassist from New York, Joey Cyphers, was in that band. You all were children, if you were born at all. Anyway, we played a bunch of just music without genre, all kinds of stuff. Just I called it People Music Project because I really felt like it was, you know, just music that people liked. It was really irrespective of where it originated or what it came from or what style it was. And I was a big fan of David Sanborn early on, and one of his very first records had a tune called The Seeker, which is one of just my favorite tunes. So this is an old tune, and I call it The Seeker Part 2 is my answer to David Sanborn's tune. So when I brought it to these guys, it just said David Sanborn tune. I said that for the first couple months we were recorded. It's like, I need to give this a title, actually. So thought back to the origin. So this is called The Seeker. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, I think we need to do golden moments. So I also am a huge fan of James Taylor. And I've been working on arranging an album's worth of his music. Applied for a grant. I got really close, almost got a grant enough to do a record, but sometime before I shuffle off, there's going to be a record of James Taylor's music. I told him this, actually. I went to he did a show a few years ago before the pandemic at the Moda Center. It was a really amazing coincidence. This friend of mine called me and said, do you know a pianist named Kevin Hayes? I said, yeah, I know. This great jazz pianist, lived in New York, named Kevin Hayes. I know Kevin Hayes. Why are you calling me? She said, well, he's staying at my house because I have an Airbnb. And apparently, he's on the road with James Taylor. And he says he knows you. I was like, yes, Kevin Hayes, give me a call. So he gave me a call and gave me a ticket to the show. So I went to see the James Taylor at the Moda Center, which was really great. And then afterwards, myself and Bryn Roberts and a couple other people went back and waited for an hour, and James came out, and I actually got to tell him how much his music has meant to me over the years and the fact that I was doing this record of his music someday. He's like, oh, well, call me if I can show you any chords. I was like, I will do that, believe me. So sometime I'm very much looking forward to doing that, because I love his music, and this is a composition of his that it's from the record called In the Pocket, which is one of my favorite records. It's not one that people necessarily know, but in this tune it was never a single, but it's this incredibly beautiful song, and the poetry of it is now if all my golden moments could be rolled into one. They would shine just like the sun on a summer's day. And after it was over, we could have them back again. With credit to the editor for striking out the rain. And all it really needed was the proper point of view. Thank you. Thank you. Let's see. Let's do, should we do Boundless?
Sure.
Yeah, let's do that. This is another old one. Can I be honest with you? Okay, this is a true confession moment. No? You say no? It would be easier not to be, so. So when I finished grad school, before I moved to New York City, I was living in Miami, and I got a month-long gig on a Carnival cruise ship, which is like often the first gig, you know, for a young musician, because it's steady work, you know? There's no way that it was laughter for me. I mean, I got this tiny little bunk that I had to share with somebody, and I mean, I did learn to windsurf, which was awesome. I love that, but I just could not get off that boat fast enough. However, I did one time, we were not supposed to fraternize with the passengers, as you can imagine. However, when you're a lounge musician, you know, you're just kind of hanging out, playing in the bar, and there was a beautiful young woman from California that I met, and I was like really enchanted and enamored, and so in the time-honored tradition of musicians, I wrote a song about her. And, you know, I never saw her after that week in 1986. But the song is still here. So it hasn't a new title. So because I wrote this song, I know that her name was Beverly. But the song is not called Beverly anymore. It's called Boundless. Hey, to be honest, that way? I was like, sorry? Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Yeah, boundless. Well, let's see, what have we got? We got time for one more, I think, to close out this evening. I want to say thank you, first of all, to Aaron and the 1905 for being a bastion, I think that is the appropriate word, of creative music in this town, for keeping this venue going against all odds through a worldwide pandemic. When there was every reason to give up the ghost and to come back stronger than it was, and to all the staff who are working so hard to make this happen, and all the musicians who are supporting this venue that come here and play here and tell their friends and bring their families and everybody. And so this is what it takes, a community to keep the music and the art form alive. So very appreciative, and appreciative to all of you for supporting this. And this is, he put my sign up somewhere. Oh, there it is, yeah. So this evening is in part a part of the Soul Restoration Project, which is an artistic project that I put together, I guess a year ago now, to kind of explore the possibility of how art could change community. Started with a bunch of performances in public spaces as we tried to bring the city back together last year, and continued into the fall when I created an artistic residency in an empty storefront that was on the corner of Killingsworth and Williams, and sort of brought that in as a place to have arts and culture and to support Black community. And that place has now become the Soul Restoration Center, which is this incredibly thriving center for youth and art and culture. And I'm really pleased to say that we are about to enter in negotiations with Oregon Community Foundation, who will be giving that building back to the Black community, and not only in its current state, with the funds to restore it and keep it, continue it sustainably as a vibrant piece of the Black community. So that, to me, says the power of art. So very happy to continue those projects as they come up, and keep trying to find ways to have art build community and restore ourselves. I do have a mailing list there, so you can sign up for email. You can scan a QR code, and that will allow you to buy or to pre-order my new CD called The New Black. If you happen to be on Instagram on Tuesday mornings, I've started this conversation series called What is the New Black? 20 minutes on Instagram Live, and I talk to amazing artists that I know about Black identity and the sort of things that formed them. This whole project has really gotten me thinking about that. So this is, I think, week 4. I talked to Esperanza Spalding and Jason Moran and Alexander Gideon. This Tuesday is MacArthur Genius winner and Grammy-winning violinist Regina Carter. So she and I will be in conversation for a little bit. So you can tune in, and you can catch that on my Instagram also. It's still up on my post, so they're living there as well. So anyway, a lot going on, and this is a very exciting Father's Day gift and a Juneteenth gift to have all you here sharing music. And once again, give it up for Machado Mijiga. This young man has an album project of his own, Gradient, which I was fortunate enough to play on, that's out. So you can find that, and you can find him everywhere, doing everything. So it's like, follow him on all social media channels. And this bassist, Sam Arnold, my first electric bassist in a trio. And man, it's just been a total pleasure. These guys are so busy, and I'm really glad that they make time to just to totally transform my music for me, so, and with me. So so we're gonna play a tune, this close with a tune that's called The Prize. I wrote this dedicated to the great pianist Jerry Allen, who was a good friend and a great inspiration, and unfortunately passed away at the age of 61 a couple of years ago. But this is for her, this is called The Prize.
Sam Arnold on the bass, Machado Mijiga on the drums, I'm Darrell Grant. Thank you all very much for coming to DG3. See you next time.